lot.
That's right, Gary. And how are you?
Could be better.
Oh?
And could be worse.
That's okay, Gary.
Hurry up, Annie. Hurry up, Annie.
You're all going too fast.
No, we're not. You're just slow.
Wait for me, Papa.
Hold on to my hand, Annie. I want to do some errands for your mother for somebody to go to work.
So you need to walk faster.
Hush, Belinda. And I don't want to be late. Mrs. Scrooge would be very angry.
You see?
Would he shout at you?
I suppose he might, Annie.
You see?
He told you.
That's enough, children.
Oh, he's just a terrible man.
Now, Annie.
You're not supposed to shout at people on Christmas Eve. Isn't that right, Papa?
Yes, child. I suppose it is. Come along now.
You don't want Papa to be late.
Careful, Tim. Don't fall off.
Yes, Papa. Hurry, Annie.
Oh, David, isn't it just a beautiful Christmas Eve?
It is indeed, Caroline.
I only wish.
I know.
I only wish we could afford something nice for the children. They're too young to understand about debts and mortgages.
Perhaps next year things will be better. If anyone else in the world held our mortgage, I...
That Mr. Scrooge! You think even he would be generous at Christmas time?
Generous? No, Caroline. Look, there's friend Elizabeth.
How could such a cross-patching Mr. Scrooge ever have such a good-hearted nephew?
It's a mystery, Caroline, but Fred is certainly the opposite of his Uncle Scrooge.
David! Caroline!
Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas, Fred and Elizabeth.
How are your children?
Quite well, thank you. Are you and Fred going to visit us tonight?
Definitely, we'll be there.
Good. We'll see you then.
Let's hurry, children.
Hurry up, Annie. We don't want Papa to be late.
It's Bob Cratchit.
Why, how are you, sir? Children, this is Mr. Scrooge's nephew and his wife. Belinda, Robbie, Annie, and Tim.
How do you do, Belinda and Robbie?
How do you do, ma'am?
Go on, say something silly.
Hello, ma'am.
And a very good day to you, Miss Annie and Master Tim.
Oh, you really know Mr. Scrooge?
Oh, yes, I really do.
Why, Fred, I think they're afraid of you.
You see, sir, they've heard me occasionally speak of Mr. Scrooge, and
Oh, I understand, Bob. In fact, I'm going to pay a call on my terrible uncle this morning. And believe me, even though I've talked to him many times, he still frightens me a little, too.
Truly?
Truly.
That's very funny.
God rest ye merry
look.
Papa, I'm going to
hear this day, remember Christ our Savior.
If you must sing, go sing somewhere else. Stay away from here, or I'll call the authorities. Go away.
Merry Christmas, sir.
Merry humbug.
Oh my God.
Merry Christmas, humbug. All that bubbling and clattering. Ah, where's my shoe? You there.
Me, sir?
Yes, you. Fetch my shoe.
What, sir?
My shoe, right there in front of you.
Idiot. This shoe, sir?
Yes, come bring it here. I'll go open the door.
Yes, sir, whatever you say, your lordship.
The old skinflint, I tell you, Mr. Sly, you just see me trying to get him to pay me for doing his laundry. It's like I was pulling his teeth.
If he had any.
That's old Scrooge for you. What does he care?
I just wish I had his money. I wouldn't be wearing shoes that look like this.
If you ask me, I can be saving it so he can take it all with me.
Well, it'd be the first time anybody got away with it. Well, I'd better take this shoe before I get thrown in the nearest prison.
And don't be thinking, you'll get a penny for your bubble either.
Thank you.
Elizabeth. I don't think I want to see Uncle Scrooge this early.
Oh, Fred.
Merry Christmas. All that hassle and bustle. Cratchit! Cratchit, where are you? Cratchit! Bah, wait. Cratchit?
Yes, sir?
You're late, Cratchit.
Yes, sir.
Late again, Cratchit.
Yes, sir. I have some shopping with my wife and the children, you see.
Cratchit! Spare me an account of the humdrum details of your hearth and home. You're supposed to be here on time.
Yes, sir.
To work!
Yes, sir.
Merry Christmas! Ah! God save you!
Humbug!
Christmas a humbug, Uncle? You don't mean that, I'm sure.
I do! Merry Christmas. What right have you to be so merry? You're poor enough.
Come then. What right do you have to be so gloomy? You're rich and—
Bah! Give me that! Merry Christmas, indeed. If I had my way, every idiot who goes about with Merry Christmas on his lips would be boiled in his own pudding and buried with a stick of holly through his heart.
Uncle!
Nephew! Keep Christmas in your way, and let me keep it in mind.
Keep it? But you don't keep it.
Well, let me leave it alone, then! Christmas, what's good made you? What's good has ever done you?
But, Uncle, I've always thought of Christmas as a good time, a kind, forgiving, charitable, pleasant time. Christmas is the only time I know when people open their hearts freely. And therefore, Uncle, though it has never put a scrap of gold or silver in my pocket, I believe it has done me good and will do me good, and I say God bless it!
Yes, sir!
Let me hear another sound from you, and you'll celebrate Christmas by losing your situation.
Yes, sir.
You're quite a powerful speaker, sir. I wonder you don't go into politics.
Now, don't be angry, Uncle. Come and have dinner with us tomorrow.
Bah! Go see the dead first.
But why? Why?
And why did you get married?
Why? Because I was in love.
Oh, you were in love! Bah! Good afternoon.
But, Uncle, you never came to see me before I got married. So why give a reason for not coming now?
Good afternoon.
I want nothing from you. I ask nothing of you. Why can't we be friends?
Good afternoon.
I'm sorry to find you so stubborn, Uncle, but I'll keep my good humor to the last. Merry Christmas.
Humbug to you, and good afternoon.
And a happy new year.
Good afternoon.
Very well, Uncle. Good afternoon. Merry Christmas, Bob.
Thank you, sir.
And best wishes to your family.
Thank you, sir. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Humbug. Merry Christmas.
Let's try here. Ready?
Oh, I suppose. But I'm telling you, Molly, it won't do any good.
The candles are dry. Ready?
Deck the halls with boughs of holly. La 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 la.
Be gone! Go away!
Yes, sir.
Be gone, I say! Humbug! I hate Christmas carols. Just take yourselves and your fa-la-las off somewhere else. Do you hear me?
We hear you, sir.
Bah!
Oh my goodness. I fear we may have some difficulty here.
Well, let's go inside and try.
Our cause is a worthy one after all.
What a grumbler. Well, I told you, Molly. I told you it wouldn't work. Old Scrooge would rather be boiled in oil before he gave us the likes of any pennies.
You'd think he'd give us one penny at least.
I'm so hungry.
You know, Betsy.
We haven't.
Oh, Molly, you know Old Scrooge wouldn't give us a penny, even to his own mom. Not even if she was dying on his ugly doorstep.
He's just an awful, terrible old man.
So, what can we do about it?
Nothing, I guess.
We haven't had anything to eat. Oh, wait, no. Molly, I'm really hungry.
I know, little sister. I know. I'm really hungry, too.
We haven't had anything to eat all day today.
I know.
Did we have anything to eat yesterday, either? I forgot.
I know, Betsy. Me, too.
I'm so tired and hungry, Molly. I think I'm just gonna lie down here on the curb and sleep.
Betsy, you can't do that!
Georgie, do something!
I'll try, Molly. You know I will.
Go! Go stand for a few pennies. Go on. Do it.
All right, I will.
Shall we?
We must go forward.
Sirs and ladies, if you'll pardon me for interruption,
I was just wondering if you can see your way clear to offer me a few pennies so as I can buy a bite of food for my two little sisters. We're all starving, you see, and haven't had no food for the last 2 days. A few pennies would be all we need. If you can spare them, good gentle ladies, if you please.
You see, we have no choice.
The children need us.
They certainly do.
Here you go, young lady.
Thank you, ma'am. Come on, Molly. Wake up, Bessie. We're going to eat tonight.
Oh, Georgie, how wonderful.
Truly, Georgie, we're really going to have some food?
Yes, indeed. Come along, Bessie. Molly will help you.
Yes? What do you want?
Scrooge and Marley's, I believe.
It is.
And do we have the pleasure of addressing Mr. Scrooge or Mr. Marley?
Mr. Marley is dead.
Oh.
He died 7 years ago this very night.
Oh, my. On Christmas Eve.
Most unfortunate, I must say.
Our credentials, sir.
Bah.
But we have no doubt that Mr. Marley's generosity was well represented in the surviving partners.
Generosity?
At this festive season of the year, Mr. Scrooge, it is more than highly desirable that we should make some slight provision for the poor and the destitute.
Ah, I see. Are there no prisons?
Why, plenty of prisons.
And the Union Workhouses, are they still in operation?
They are, sir, but I wish I could say they were not.
Oh, well, I was afraid from what you said at first that some lunatic had interfered with those excellent establishments.
Oh, my goodness.
Sir, we believe that prisons and workhouses scarcely furnish Christian cheer with mind and body to multitudes.
This is why at this special time of year, a few of us are trying to raise a fund for the poor to buy some meat and drink and means of warmth.
What shall we put you down for?
Nothing.
Ah, I see. You will want to remain anonymous.
No, I wish to be left alone.
Oh, dear.
I can't afford to make aloe people merry. Let those who are badly off go to the prisons and workhouses.
Sir, many of them cannot go there.
And many would rather die.
Well, if they would rather die, then they had better just do it and decrease the surplus population.
Mr. Scrooge!
Sir!
It's enough for a man to care for his own business without interfering with other people's.
Well.
Sirs, ladies, good afternoon.
Well, of all
the... It seems we're wasting our time here.
I should say so.
Ah, what about Pumpkin? Yes, Cratchit. What do you want?
Mr. Scrooge, sir, that's why I remind you that it's about time 5 o'clock, sir.
So?
Well, it's Christmas Eve, and I want to do a tiny bit of shopping.
Shopping? On 15 shillings a week?
Yes, sir. And you did say that I could leave early today.
I did? When did I say that?
Well, sir...
Bah! Never mind that. If you're going to pace around the office telling me what time it is for 2 more hours, you might as well go. You're no good to me here.
Thank you, sir.
I suppose you'll want all day tomorrow off.
It's quite convenient, sir.
Well, it is not convenient, and it's not fair.
No, sir.
It's not fair that I pay you a day's wages of no work.
But it's only once a year, sir.
Humbug! That's a poor excuse for picking a man's pocket every 25th of December. But I suppose you must have a whole day.
Yes, sir, if I may.
But be here all the earlier the next morning.
Oh, yes, sir. I will, sir. I promise. Yes, sir. I thank you, sir. Good night, sir. And Merry Christmas, sir.
Humbug!
Thank you.
What? What is it? Oh, it's humbug. All this Christmas clatter and jangle. It's unsettled me. I just need to sit down with my newspapers and have a little supper. Yes, that's just what I need.
People have been very generous this year.
And it's good to know we've been so successful.
That Mrs. Church, though.
Fortunately, not too many people are like him.
Some of the things he said. How can anyone be so heartless?
I don't know. We mustn't judge him.
Perhaps he had an unhappy life.
Well, if he had, I'm certain it was his own fault.
Perhaps so.
Well, Merry Christmas to you.
And Merry Christmas to you.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare Him room. And heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven and heaven and nature sing.
Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas!
Senses.
Because the little thing affects them. It may be a slight disorder of the stomach, a bit of undigested beef, a blot of mustard, a crumb of cheese or potato. There's more of gravy than the gravy about you, whatever you are. Humbug, I tell you. Humbug!
Oh!
Mercy! Dreadful apparition. Why do you trouble me?
Do you believe in me or not?
I do! I must! But why do spirits walk the earth? And why do they come to me?
It's required of every man that a spirit should walk among his fellow men. If the spirit does not go forth in life, it's condemned to do so after death. Whoa!
You are chained. Tell me why.
I wear this chain I forged in life. I made it link by link, yard by yard. I put it on my own free will, and my own free will I wore. Is the pattern strange to you? Or do you know the length and weight of the strong pole you bear yourself? Is it as long as this 7 Christmas Eves ago? You have labored on it since. It's a ponderous chain.
Jacob, old Jacob Marley, tell me more. Speak comfort to me, Jacob.
I have none to give. A little more time is all that's permitted to me. I cannot rest. I cannot stay. I cannot linger anywhere. In life, my spirit never walked beyond the counting house, and weary journeys lie before me.
7 years dead and traveling all the time?
Whole time. No rest. No peace. Whoa! Captive bound, double iron. Yes, such was I. Such was I.
But you're always a good man of business, Jacob.
Business? Mankind is my business. The
common welfare was my business. Charity, mercy, forbearance, and benevolence were all my mercy.
Jacob.
Whoa.
Jacob.
Listen. There is a hope and a chance for you to escape my fate.
You're always a good friend to me, Jacob. I thank you.
Listen, you will be haunted by three spirits. Spread the first tomorrow when the bell tolls one. Spread the second on the next night and the last. Spread the second on the next night at the same hour. The third upon the next night when the last stroke 12 has ceased to vibrate. Look to see me no more. Ebenezer, remember what has passed between us.
Clock. When the bell tolls one. Hello? Is anyone there? Was it a dream or not? Are you the spirit whose coming was foretold to me?
I am.
Who and what are you?
I am the ghost of Christmas past.
Long past?
No, your past.
What business brings you here?
Your welfare.
I'm much obliged, spirit, but I think a night of unbroken rest would do me more good.
Touch my hand.
Where are we going?
Walk with me. Look.
Good heaven. I was a boy here.
Your lip is trembling, and what is that upon your cheek?
Nothing.
Nothing. Do you remember the way?
Remember it? I could walk it blindfolded.
Strange to have forgotten it for so many years.
I remember it all. All the boys. Tommy Jenkins, Jamie Evans, Christopher Robinson, the whole school. I remember them all. At Christmas time, they all went home, shouting and happy.
But the school is not quite deserted. A solitary boy, neglected by his friends, is left here still.
Yes. Yes, I know. I remember. Why, it's myself when I was a boy. Poor boy. I wish... No. But it's too late now.
Do you remember this day? Look.
I wish the others would come back. Christmas is so lonely.
Look.
Be me rise, Master Scrooge.
Yes, sir, Master Pringle.
All the other boys have went to spend Christmas with their families. But you, Master Scrooge, will stay here during the entire holiday.
Yes, sir.
Your father has no desire to see at this time of year, nor apparently at any other time of year.
Yes, sir, I know.
My sister, Miss Pringle, and I find your continued presence here entirely inconvenient. But even most handsomely, reimbursed to accept their duties and to comply with your father's request that you stay.
Thank you, sir.
You remain in this room at all times unless you are sleeping. You shall cause no further inconvenience to my sister nor to myself. If you should behave in a disobedient or disrespectful fashion, I will take steps. Do you understand me?
Yes, sir. Brother Phineas?
Dear sister, can't you see I'm occupied?
Indeed, brother, my vision's not impaired. However, I must leave you immediately.
In regard to what, dear sister?
In regard to young Master Scrooge, dear brother.
Can this be?
Evidently it is.
Well, then I suspect we must allow it.
Unfortunately, we must.
Wait here, Master Scrooge.
Come, we must hasten.
Sir!
Fan, this little Fan, my sister.
Ebenezer, guess who I am?
Fan, is it really you?
Yes, brother, it's me, Fan. Oh, Ebenezer.
But Fan, why are you here?
I've come to bring you home, Ebenezer, to bring you home, home, home.
Home, Fan? Really?
Yes, home for good and all, home forever and ever.
But what does Father say?
Father is so much kinder than he used to be. He spoke to me so gently one night when I was going to bed. I was not afraid to ask him once more if he might come home.
What did he say?
He said yes, he could, and he sent me in a coach to bring you.
A coach?
Naturally, we're both deeply disappointed.
Oh, yes, indeed we are.
We so look forward to having your delightful company during the holiday.
But, dear sister, his father summons him, so we must accept our disappointment gracefully.
And so we shall, dear brother. Ask her.
Mrs. Scrooge, in regard to the financial arrangements which had already been made.
Oh, yes. Father says you should keep the stipend.
Thank goodness.
Most kind of him.
In return for your kindness to my dear brother.
Come along, Ebenezer. Let's hurry.
I'm coming, Pan. You'll have the merriest Christmas ever.
She was a delicate creature whom a breath might have withered. She had a large heart.
So she had. You're right. I'll not deny it, Spirit.
She died a woman and had, as I think, children.
One child.
True, your nephew.
Yes, my nephew, Fred.
Do you remember this day? Look.
Remember this day? I was a prentice to you.
My back. Tra-la. Yo ho there. Ebenezer. Jacob.
Yes, sir.
Yo ho there, my boys. No more work tonight. Christmas Eve, Jacob. Christmas, Ebenezer. Close up the shop before a man can say Jack Robinson.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir, Mr. Fezziwig.
Highly ho. Clean away, my lads. Let's have lots of room here. Highly ho, Jacob. Cheer up, Ebenezer. Come along, everyone. Dick Wilkins, where are you?
Here, sir.
What ho, my love?
Ready, Fezziwig. You better stop dancing about like a schoolboy.
Nonsense, Felicity, my love.
You'll be sorry tomorrow.
Tomorrow's a long way off, my dear. Oh, my back.
Now, Freddy, what did I tell you? Come along, my girls. Yoo-hoo, Flora, Fauna, Fiona.
Ah, 'tis the most beauteous daughters, just in time to celebrate Christmas with their dear old dad and mom. Give your papa a hug, my girls.
Oh, Papa, you sweet old dear, I have no time for nonsense just now.
Your papa speaks truly, Miss Flora. You do indeed look mighty dear, sister.
I thank you most kindly, Dick Wilkins. Now do be a dear and give the church food.
Now, Flora, bright this, Papa. You can put the decorations.
I'd be rightly honored to assist you, Miss Flora.
I thank you most kindly, Dick Wilkins. Now do be a dear and hang the garland over the door.
Tom and Eliza Jenkins.
I brought a cake.
Look, it's Daddy.
And Maggie.
And Jamie.
It's good to see you, Tom.
Hi, it's good to see you. And your family doing so well, so.
Freddy, stop it. Freddy, stop it.
Stop it, Freddy.
Freddy, stop.
It's just once a year, my love. Just keep dancing.
Freddy, stop. I'm dizzy.
Stop it,
Freddy. Stop it.
Surprise!
What? What is it?
Look, mistletoe.
Well, 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 mistletoe, my love.
Oh, no, you don't, Freddy. That's for the young people.
Come here. Mwah. There.
You old fool.
Look, more company.
Well, straighten your wig, Freddy. You look ridiculous.
Let me help you, Papa. You crack ice cream with Papa.
Look, my love, it's Bella Kathy, home from school.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Ebenezer, look who's here.
Belle.
Why, it's Belle.
Merry Christmas.
He spent about a few pounds of immortal money. Is that too much to do?
It wasn't that, Spirit. He had the power to make our service a pleasure or a toil. And the pleasure he gave us was just as great as if it had cost a fortune.
What does it matter?
It's just that I should like to be able to say a word or two to like my clerk just now.
Ah, would you indeed? Look, my time grows short.
I must know your decision very soon, Ebenezer.
Yes, we would be great business partners, I agree.
With legacy from my uncle, we have adequate funds at our disposal.
Yes, yes, it's very tempting. We have the money, we have all the knowledge. We've almost finished our apprenticeships.
Exactly. What do you say?
I say let's do it.
Excellent. I can see it now, on our doorway, Scrooge and Marley.
In 10 years, 20 years, at the most, we'll be rich. Rich, Jacob.
We'll be rich.
We'll be rich.
Oh, Belle, just look at the two of them, chatting away about enormously big and important business affairs, I would imagine.
Yes, Kathy, business is really all that Ebenezer seems to talk about these days.
Well, he's glad he's ambitious. After all, he won't marry him if he was lazy and shiftless, nice and coarse.
Oh, it's not that, Kathy.
Well then, really? What is it?
Oh, I just don't know.
Oh, Belle. Oh, woohoo! Jacob, wait for me. Are you coming, Belle?
Not yet. Kathy, you go ahead.
Well, you won't be alone with Ebenezer, don't you?
Well, I understand.
Belle, such wonderful news. Jacob and I have decided to be business partners.
I'm very happy for you, Ebenezer.
It will be such a great success. You'll see. Before you know it, we'll be rich. We'll be surrounded with gold, bags and bags of it.
And that's what you want, isn't it?
Oh, yes, it is. In a few years, you and I will be married. You'll have a big house, a carriage, and gold and jewels.
Ebenezer.
Yes, Belle? What is it?
What if I told you that I don't care very much about being rich?
What? You don't care? Not at all?
No, I don't. Not really.
What do you mean you don't care? Everyone wants to be rich. I want to be rich.
Yes, yes, I know you do.
Well, what's wrong with that?
Nothing, Ebenezer, nothing. If that's what you really want.
It is.
More than anything?
More than anything. You can understand that, can't you?
Yes, I see.
And just what do you see?
The young fool. Can't you see what she's trying to tell you?
No. I don't understand, Ebenezer. The only thing I see is that my feelings don't seem to mean very much to you anymore.
Why, Belle, that's not true.
This passion of yours, this desire to be rich, to acquire so much gold.
But that's the way of the world, of business.
Oh, listen to her. Try to understand.
You just don't understand, Ebenezer. You can't even recognize what I feel. And oh, I wish I could feel otherwise, but I just can't. But my dear, and this is so difficult to say, but I truly believe that if you were free today, you wouldn't want to choose me or anyone.
But have I ever asked you to release me from my promise?
No, not in words. Never.
Then how have I?
Yes, you've changed more than you know. Ebenezer, you've chosen your way of life. You want to be rich, very well then be rich. But I don't want a husband who cares more for his bags of gold than he does for me.
But I...
Perhaps my leaving will bring you some pain, or maybe even a little sadness. But I truly believe that you will be so absorbed in your pursuit of wealth, you won't miss me very much at all. You'll be glad I let you go.
No, Belle!
I hope you'll be very happy in the life you've chosen.
But Belle...
Goodbye, Ebenezer.
Don't just stand there. Go after her!
These are but the mere shadows of things that have happened. They are what they are.
Remove me from this place. Haunt me no longer. I cannot bear it. Spirit, take me away. Please. Spirit! Anything to teach me, let me profit by it.
Touch my robe.
Okay, then. But where are they all going? They all seem to have special places to go.
It's Christmas Day. They do have places to go. They have family and friends to visit. The churches will be full. Then Christmas dinner, rich ones and poor ones. Christmas dinner is the very best one of the year.
Hurry, Papa, hurry!
We're coming, Annie.
Hurry, Papa, hurry!
Stop that, child. You're making your poor father dizzy. Now run on back home, help your brother Peter. Tim and I will be back later.
Yes, Papa. Goodbye, Annie.
Now, Tim, we're off.
Please!
Merry Christmas, Caroline.
Merry Christmas. We're on our way to church. Would you like to join us?
Oh, David and I went to church earlier this morning. He's visiting his cousins now.
We'll see you later then.
Oh, yes. Until later.
Miss Dilbert, as I live and breathe.
Merry Christmas, Mr. Sly.
Thank you. The same to you, my dear.
What have you got in your bundle?
Where?
There, in your bundle. What is it?
Oh, I'll tell you, Miss Dilbert. This bundle here is full of amazing things. Absolutely amazing.
What? What?
Oh, a few odds and ends. Like a few bottles of Christmas cheer.
No!
Right. For me and my friends. Just my favorite friends. Mind you, to share.
Oh?
And what might you have in your bundle, Miss Dilbert?
Now, wouldn't you like to know?
You can tell me now. Ain't we the best of friends?
Well, since you put it that way, I've got a dozen apples.
No.
A cake.
No.
Topped with sticks of cinnamon and sugar almonds.
No.
And that's not all, mind you. I got a whole entire cooked Christmas goose.
I don't believe it.
Well, it's true.
Miss Dover, where did you get all that stuff?
That's for me to know and for you to find out.
Well, you didn't pay for it, did you?
Of course not. What'd you take me for? I'm not so stupid that I have to pay for everything that I want.
Forget me, Miss Dover. You're indeed a woman of rare and charming insight. I take my hat off to you.
Thank you, Mr. Sly. I'm sure you could have done as well yourself given the opportunity.
I know about that, Miss Dover. Your talent's quite amazing. Again, I take my hat off to you.
Come with me.
I never realized.
Never realized what?
Why, how much, how very much.
Come.
I never really saw before.
Come.
Where are we going?
To the home of your clerk, Bob Crafton.
That would do, children. Linda, you can set out the plates. Robbie, you can set out the cups and spoons.
Yes, Mama.
Yes, Mama.
I'll put it before you will.
Oh, no, you won't. I'm twice as fast as you are.
Careful, Robbie. You almost made me drop the plates.
You almost made me break the cups.
Now be very careful, children. Those are the only plates and cups we have. If you break them, you just might not be able to have any Christmas dinner.
Oh, that would be very terrible.
No Christmas dinner? Truly?
Well, you never know. After all, how can you have a fine Christmas dinner without a plate?
We'd better be very careful.
Right. I wouldn't like to miss our Christmas dinner.
It's the best dinner of the whole year.
Very nice. Very nice indeed.
Yes. Indeed, Mother. Our goose is the biggest we've ever had.
Oh, Peter, you say that every year.
Now, Mother, you mustn't treat me like a child. Fact, Father's almost found me a job.
Almost.
5 shillings a week.
Yes, Peter, I know.
And I am wearing one of Father's shirt collars today, so that means I'm nearly grown up.
Yes, son, you truly have grown so much. You really are almost grown up. But even though you're wearing one of your father's shirt collars, you have a way to go before it actually fits you.
Oh, Mother.
Peter, go stir the potatoes again for me, please.
Yes, Mom.
Yum. Mama, Peter's eating potatoes.
That's not fair. I want some, too.
Peter, leave some for the rest of the family.
Oh, I was just trying to see if there was good last year.
how you've grown, and Peter, how dignified you are today.
They seem very happy. I wonder how they manage.
On 15 shillings a week?
Yeah.
Look, there's Papa and Tiny Tim!
Quick, we're behind!
Yes, hide us! Behind! We're behind! We're behind!
Papa!
Tim!
Let me help you, Father.
There you are, Timmy!
Why, where is Aunt Martha?
Not coming.
Not coming.
Oh, no!
Not coming on Christmas Day?
Here she is, Papa!
Here I am, Father.
Martha, I knew you would be here.
Now, Peter, it's time for you to fetch the goods from the baker's.
Oh, yes.
My own words.
But I didn't mean...
Then who are you to say what men shall live and what men shall die? It may be that in the sight of heaven, you are less fit to live than this poor man's child.
It may be so, Spirit.
Come with me.
Must we go? I want to see...
My time is short. Come.
Where do you take me?
Look for yourself.
Why, it's Fred.
Elizabeth, aren't you ready yet? Everything looks perfect, Elizabeth. It's too bad Uncle Scrooge will miss all this. Elizabeth, where is everyone?
Oh, Fred, you're always so impatient. They'll be here soon.
Well, I certainly hope so.
Elizabeth, Fred, it's Caroline. She and Dave are here.
Hello, Fred, Elizabeth.
And apparently
Hello.
So is
Merry
everyone
Christmas,
else.
Fred and Elizabeth. Merry Christmas.
It's so terribly cold outside. So good to be in.
Indeed it is. Even with the sun shining.
The house looks so beautiful!
Well, I could use a cup of steaming hot punch.
Excellent idea. So could I.
Is that the heavenly aroma of gooseberry pie, perhaps?
Where are the children?
They're playing in the snow.
Let's join them. Good idea.
I think it would be best if you and Fred just let the children play by themselves for a while.
Caroline's right, Fred. Let the younger children play their own games.
I'm very disappointed, of course, but I bow to your superior wisdom, oh beautiful wife of mine.
Just like our friend.
Oh my, it certainly is.
He's such a merry fellow, always ready to laugh.
You see, there he goes again.
Do tell us, Fred, why are you laughing now?
Well, I was thinking of my Uncle Scrooge. And how he said Christmas was a humbug. He believed it, too.
More the shame for him, Fred.
Oh, he's a comical old fellow. I have nothing to say against him.
Well, I'm sure he's very rich, Fred. At least you always tell me so.
What of that, my dear? His wealth is no use to him. He doesn't do any good with it for himself or anyone else.
I have no patience with him.
Oh, I have. I'm sorry for him. Who suffers most by his own temper? He does. He takes it into his head to dislike us, and what's the result?
The result is that he will miss a very good dinner.
No, Elizabeth. I mean that the result of him taking a dislike to us is, I think, he loses some pleasant moments which could do him no harm. I mean to give him the same chance every year, though, whether he likes it or not. Because I pity him.
Oh, Fred.
And I intend to go to his musty old office year after year and ask him here again and again.
And I refuse to come here again and again.
Perhaps to Uncle Scrooge, a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
To Uncle Scrooge.
To Uncle Scrooge.
I thank you. I am very...
Look, the children are building a simply gigantic snowman.
I want to go see.
Wait for us, Fred.
See you
later. Dashing through the snow.
No, Scrooge.
I'm
so
My spirit's life is over. My life upon this earth is very brief. It ends tonight.
Tonight?
Tonight at midnight, the spirit of Christmas present will end. There will be others after me, but my time ends now.
Are you the ghost of Christmas yet to come? You are about to show me shadows of things that have not happened, but will happen in time for us. Ghost of the future, I fear you more than any spirit I have seen. But as I know your purpose is to do me good, and as I hope to live to be another man from what I was, I am prepared to bear company and to do it with a thankful heart. Will you not speak to me?
About it. Either way, I only know he's dead.
When did he die, Miss Dilbert?
Last night, I believe.
What was the matter with him?
Who knows? Or even cares, Miss McDougal.
What's he done with all this money?
Left it to his company, perhaps. He hasn't left it to me. That's all I know.
Why don't we throw a party and volunteer?
I don't mind going if a lunch is provided. I must be fit if I'm to go.
I'll go if anybody else will. To be honest, I'm not sure I wasn't his most particular friend. After all, I did clean his house once in a while.
And after all, I used to collect his trash.
And after all, I washed his shirts.
Say, I have another idea.
Why not?
Let's hurry. Maybe we're not too late.
Spirit, tell me who is dead. I beg you.
Now, it's time to set up the shop. There, the shelves. Now it's time for business. Wait a minute. There. Buy and sell your cast-offs and rubbish here. Anything bought or sold. Bring your own pots, pans, and bottles. Aha. It's a customer. Or a thief. Who's there? Friend or foe? Aha. Customers. Miss Dilbert, Willie Haggerty, and Miss McDougal. What can I do for you?
I'll go first.
You got some bed curtains? You stole his bed curtains.
Yeah.
Good for you, Miss McDougal. Here's what I'll give you.
I'm off.
Willie, what'd you get?
Not much. I let the ladies go first.
Here's what I'll give you.
Well, I'm off.
All right, Miss Dilbert. What'd you get? You took his shoes? Good for you, Miss Dilbert. Here's what I'll give you. I'm kind to the lady, so I'll give you too much. Say, Miss Dilbert, would you like to share a glass of something with me?
I'd be delighted.
Yes, I see, Spirit. I see. This man may speak up. Why, this man could be myself. Oh, Spirit, if there's any person in this town that feels some emotion caused by this man's death,
Show that person to me, Spirit. I beseech you.
David, you've been gone for so long.
Caroline, you shouldn't be out in the cold. Let's go in.
No, no. Tell me the news first. Is it good or bad?
I can hardly believe it, but there is still hope.
If you're alive, there is. Nothing is past him. If such a miracle happened.
He's passed from Linton, Caroline. He's dead.
Dead? Oh, no. Heaven forgive me, but I can't help feeling relieved at the news.
I imagine heaven would, too. But I learned some time before I went there, he passed.
To whom will our debt be transferred?
I don't know yet. Before that time, we'll be ready with the money. Besides,
no one could be as heartless as he.
Let's go home now.
Yes, David.
The only feeling caused by this man's death is pleasure. Oh, Spirit, show me some tenderness, some sadness connected with the death.
And he took the little child and set him in the midst of them.
The light hurts my eyes. It's all right, child. My eyes are better now. The candlelight makes them weak. Well, it should be almost time for your father to come home.
Past time, Mother. I think he's been walking slower these past few evenings.
Yet, with tiny Tim on his shoulders, I've known him to walk very fast indeed.
Yes, so have I.
So have I.
So have I.
So have I.
Me too.
And your father loved him so, it was no trouble at all.
There's your father at the door.
They'll be ready before Sunday.
Sunday? Then you went there today, Robert?
Yes, I did. I wish you could have gone with me, but you'll see it often enough. I promised him that we would walk there on Sundays. He would have liked a tree so tall and strong. And my little boy, my child, Tim, my child. Why, Tim?
Robert, we don't know why. We can't know why. But none of us will ever forget our Tim.
No, we never will.
Never.
Never, ever.
Never, Papa.
Don't be sad, Papa.
I only wish we could have helped them. If only he could have left something. But we had nothing to pay for doctors and medicines. But we must remember how patient Tim was. Perhaps that will comfort us.
It will, Robert. It will.
Spirit, I feel our parting moment is at hand. Spirit, I must know who. Who is the dead man all these people have spoken of? Spirit, before I draw another stone, tell me, are these shadows of things that may be only? Oh, Spirit, answer me. Ebenezer Scrooge, I am the man? Oh, no, Spirit. Oh, no. Spirit, listen to me. I am not the man I was. Why show me this if I am past all hope? Oh, Spirit, tell me that I may yet be another man from what I was. Tell me that I may erase the writing on the stone. Spirit, I will honor Christmas in my heart and try to keep it all the year. I will live in the past, the present, and the future. The spirits of all three shall live within me. Oh, Spirit, tell me that I may yet live to be another man. Spirit, tell me, please, I beg you. Tell me that I may yet live. Spirit, please, I beg you. Spirit! Shop in the next street.
Of course I do.
An intelligent child. A remarkable child. Do you know whether they've sold the prize turkey that was hanging up there?
Not the little one, the big one.
What? The one as big as me?
What a delightful child. It's a pleasure to talk to her. Yes, my dear. That's what I mean.
It's still there.
Is it? Good. Go and buy it.
Ha ha ha. That's a good joke, sir.
No. I mean it. Go and buy it and tell them to bring it here so I can tell them where to take it. Come back in less than 5 minutes and I'll give you half a crown.
Half a crown? Yes, sir.
I'll send it to Bob Cratchit. He won't know who sent it. It's twice the size of the time to tell. A Merry Christmas. Today, your debt no longer exists.
But Mr. Scrooge?
I assure you, sir, I am fully aware of what I'm saying.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Scrooge!
Don't thank me. I don't know who paid it.
Oh, yes, you do, and I do thank you, but why are you doing this for us?
It's Christmas, my dear. People do many unexpected things at Christmas time. I just ask that you both try to think of me kindly from now on.
Yes, sir.
Of course we will.
Now, I wonder if you could help me with something.
Yes, sir.
Elizabeth, do you think everything is almost ready?
Almost, Fred.
I'm truly looking forward to Christmas dinner this year. Our very first Christmas dinner with our dearest friends in our very own home.
Oh, Fred, my dear, I completely agree.
Elizabeth! Forgive me for just barging in on you, but your maid let me in at...
Caroline, you're always welcome. You know that. Is there something wrong?
Oh, no. It's just that, David and I have a surprise for you.
A surprise?
Good. I love surprises. Where is it?
What is it? All right, David, you can bring in the surprise now.
Surprise.
What surprise?
Well, there is someone who...
Well, I don't believe it.
Don't believe what?
A Merry Christmas, Fred.
Merry? Why, it's nothing less than a miracle. Yes, Merry Christmas.
Fred, who is?
Who indeed? Meet my wife, Elizabeth.
Fred, what's going on? Forgive me, sir, but who are you?
I am your Uncle Scrooge, my dear.
Oh, my goodness.
You invited me to dinner, remember?
Of course I do.
So I've come to have dinner with my family. Will you forgive me for taking so long to visit?
There's nothing to forgive, Uncle Scrooge.
We'll let y'all visit for a while.
Won't you stay?
We'll be back later, Fred.
We'll see you in a little while, then.
Don't forget to bring the children.
We won't. Until later.
Shall we have a pleasant visit now? We have a wonderful Christmas dinner planned for later.
unforgettable dinner.
I'm looking forward to it, friend, and to our visit.
Miss Dilber!
Merry Christmas, Mr. Fly.
I'm delighted you remembered to meet me here.
Now, how could I forget Mr. Sly?
I have a little something for you in favor of the day.
And I have a little something for you.
No.
Yes.
Well, let me see it. Oh, Miss Dilber, you shouldn't have.
Why not? Don't you like it?
I love it. It's the most beautiful tie I've ever had.
Oh, Mr. Sly, you shouldn't have. The colors suit me, don't you think?
You look beautiful, Miss Dilber, just beautiful.
Thank you, Mr. Sly. You know what, Mr. Sly? I feel like giving you a great big hug.
You don't have to do anything like that.
There. That wasn't so bad, was it?
Well.
A wonderful dinner. A wonderful family.
Hold on tight, Tim.
Wee, giddy up.
Oh, Bob, you'll drop the poor child.
Papa, I'm going too.
Not now, children. It's very cold outside and we have friends to visit.
We'll play later, children. You know, my dear, I'm so puzzled about that huge turkey appear on our doorstep this morning. Where did it come from? Who could have put it there?
Well, if it was a mistake, we'll find out soon enough, I suppose. No one forgets about a turkey that big.
It was a wonderful turkey, wasn't it?
Bigger than Tiny Tim.
It was bigger than Tiny Tim and Little Annie put together.
Look!
Oh my, can this be? Is it?
Yes, I'm afraid so.
Oh dear.
What is it, Mama? What are you looking at?
Oh, it's him.
Who, Annie?
It's Mr. Scrooge.
Oh. Mm-hmm.
Now, children, do try to behave yourselves.
Shh. A Merry Christmas, Bob. What, sir?
How do you do, Mrs. Cratchit? Miss Cratchit? Please don't be afraid, child.
Sir, this is Annie and Tim.
How do you do?
Our eldest Martha, Peter, Belinda, and Robbie.
How do you do? It's a great pleasure to meet you all at last.
It is?
Robbie! Are you really Mr. Scrooge?
Hush, child. It's all right, Mom. Yes, my dear. I am Mr. Scrooge.
Sir, but you... That is... I thought... What?
Why?
It's a very long story, Mom, but I'm a different man today. That's all that matters.
Yes, sir. If you say so, sir.
Let me make amends for the past. First of all, I want to raise your salary.
Oh, sir.
Oh, Bob, how wonderful.
A Merry Christmas to you, Bob. A merrier Christmas than I have given you for many in the past.
Mr. Scrooge, only you could imagine how we, I thought of you in the past.
Mrs. Cratchit, I'm sure you were justified in whatever you thought. But that's all in the past now. Let us think about the future. Now, if you and Bob will permit me, I would like to help your son Tim. We will see if we can find a doctor who will make Tim walk.
Oh, Mr. Scrooge!
Merry Christmas, Mr. Scrooge!
Merry Christmas.
And God bless us, everyone!
We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas.
organization to the play. She began planning and holding practices in early October. Even though it was often hectic and sometimes crazy, she never really lost her patience and continued to encourage each cast member.
In addition to her directorship, Mrs. Chukta personally made sure the props, decorations, and costumes for tonight's show were complete. Most of everything on this stage in some way came from her house or her personal stash.
Students from Bridges want to recognize Ms. Casey Chukta for her hard work and dedication to her 2016 performance of the
Christmas show. And the stash that they speak of is right here on the stage. And I'm so thankful.